B.R. Ambedkar, anti-thinker and social reformer in the emancipation of social status of women in Hindu society. The paper also analyzed the relevance of his idea in the contemporary feminist discourse on gender equality under the Hindu social system. His main argument is that gender relations are artificially constructed under the Hindu social order, which are not only mold attitude of Hindu towards their women, but also conditioned women to conform to a stereotype feminine behavior. My aim is to highlight the women problem at the grassroots level, at raising the awareness on under inequality characterized by the caste patriarchy and challenging the legitimacy of the established Hindu social order. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is widely regarded as the father of Indian constitution, was one of the greatest social reformer of modern India. He tensely worked for improving the social status of women and depressed classes. He tried to do away with the hurdles in the path of advancement of women in India. He drafted a common civil code for Hindus and other sections of this society. He was among the few Indian social political thinkers who dwelt deeply on the Hindu social system and status of women in it. His education in England and America exposed him to Western ideas of humanism and rationalism. The low status of women in Hindu society shocked him. He not only worked hard at the grassroots level, he not only worked hard at the grassroots level to increase the awareness about the poor status of women, but also wrote extensively to challenge the views on gender relations that were validated by Shastras and sanctioned by tradition. He believed that women should get the opportunity of their all-round development, and besides their physical well-being, their socio-cultural rights should be taken care of. He wanted that women of all the sections of the society should get their dues, and their dignity and modesty should be protected. He worked hard to challenge the unequal gender relations obtaining in the Hindu society so that he can be rebuilt on the basis of the modern democratic ideas of liberty, equality and fraternity. The main objective of my study is, the study highlights the harsh reality of suppression struggle and towards the women facing their daily life in Indian society. Hardship of Dalit women are not only due to their poverty or lack of education, but are directly born out of the exploitation and the suppression of Dalit by upper caste, which are sanctified by Hindu religious scripture. A number of Hindu religious books, including Manu Samriti, Atharvedas, and Vishnu Samriti, and divine status granted to them by the Brahmin Hindu upper caste persist, build a society by them where the gender equality was for a crime. Treatises like Manusmriti created a satisfied caste system which did not equal status of men and women. Manusmriti says women cannot get education like independent decision or acquire wealth. It not only objectifies the woman and promotes child marriage, justifies violence against and atrocities on women. India is to develop an understanding of the gender issues, and it is next to possible for the women to grow and realize their potential. Obviously, it is essential to organize the women and develop their leadership, only political and economic empowerment, making them self-confident and equal participation of Dalit women in Indian politics. The politics can bring out the social changes in India. This should be our final objective. The paper seeks to equate Dr. Ambedkar's views on the problem of women in pre- and post-independent India, the secondary data collected from internet, government publication, newspapers, published papers, books, and speeches delivered by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar in parliament, conferences, and meetings formed by the study material of study. And now I want to discuss the Dharmashastra and gender discrimination. It was Manusmriti and is going to acceptable that brought about a participant decline in the status of the woman. The Manusmriti says that women are not to be trusted as the seducing man in nature. It forbids men from being the company of even mothers and sisters. In the stage of their lives, should women be allowed to live independently, and they should always be under the protection of males, father in childhood, husband in adulthood, and son in old age. Manu allowed men to divorce their wives at will, but instead that women should not be given this right under any circumstances. Men were even allowed to abandon and sell their wives even after their repudiation by her husband. A woman was not free and could not become the legitimate wife of another. A wife should be subjected to physical punishment by her husband. She was condemned to a slave. Mithakshara Yagpalakshya states that it is a woman's duty to follow her husband decades, and in this lies her salvation. Even if what her husband is moral, the wife should follow his words without any demur. A woman whose husband is away from the home should not entertainment, should not make yourself beautiful, and should not celebrate the festivals, and should not go out from the home. Like Shudras, the study of Vedas was prohibited for women too. According to Dr. Ambedkar's perspective, there were three important pillars responsible for the discrimination against the women and their status in society. One, religious scriptures like Manusmriti, Dharmashastra, Dharmasutras, and after the modern literature also. Second one, caste system, and third one, Edomomi. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar struggled for the gender equality. Dr. Ambedkar challenged the ideology foundation of the caste hierarchy that denied the equality, freedom, and dignity to Hindu women. He believed that reason and not the hurdles caste system should determine the social relation. In Halation of the Caste, he suggested that Hindu mind should be purged of the thraldom of Shastras. To quote him, make every man and woman free from the thraldom of the Shastras, cleanse their minds for the princess notice founded on the Shastras, and he or she will enter dine and intermarry without your telling him or her to do so. He believed that patriarchy perpetrated through the endogamy, education, inter-caste marriages, and inter-dining were the tools for annihilation of the caste. Dr. Ambedkar's perception of the women issues is emphasizes on their right of education, equality, and property, and their involvement in the politics process was exactly that Western feminists were demanding at that time. As J.S. Mill wrote in The Subjugation of the Woman, the legal subordinate of one sex to another is wrong, pre or one of the chief hindrances to the woman development. It ought to be replaced by the principle of the perfect equality, admitting no privilege or power on the one side or disability on the other side. Dr. Ambedkar movements for the woman. While launching his movement in 1920, he said, "We shall see the better days soon, and our progress will greatly accelerated by male education is preceded by sight with female education." He launched a powerful movement against the Hindu social order. He founded the two newspapers, Muknayak 1920 and Bahispit Bharat 1927, through which he propagated his views on these issues. These journals championed the cause of the both women and the oppressed classes. An association of the women was founded in Bombay in 1928. Its first president was Ambedkar's wife, Ramabai. Addressing his press conference in 1931, Radhabai Wadle said, "It is better to die 100 times than live a life full of humiliation. We are ready to lay down our lives for winning our struggles." It was Ambedkar's encouragement that gave voice to Radhabai, and many such women gave them the courage to make such bold statements. More than 500 participated in Kalaram Mandir movement in Nasik 1930, and many of them were arrested and had to face maltreatment in prison. It was Ambedkar who imbued women with self-respect and firm determination. Dr. Ambedkar's role in empowerment of Indian women. Hindu Court Bill. Hindu Court Bill from 1948. The property of a dying man has to be shared equally among his widow daughter and son, which according to provision law was entitled only for his son. The right of any woman over his inherent self-obtained property should be not limited. Instead, it was made absolute. It can be proceeded as she wished, allowing either partner to life for divorce on certain grounds such as domestic violence and definitely extra. The granting of maintenance to the wife if she decided to live separately due to divorce on grounds as mentioned above, making monogamy mandatory. Also, this is regarding the guardianship of the child in case of divorce were mentioned under these laws. And now I am discussing what is the relevancy act after Ambedkar. Mines Maternity Benefit Act, he formed in Parliament, Woman Labour Welfare Act, Woman Child Labour Protection Act, Maternity Benefit for Woman Labour, Restoration of the Ban to Employment of the Woman Underground Work in Coal Mines. Dr. Ambedkar and Bharat Ratna. In 1990, Dr. Ambedkar, the chief architect of our constitution, was bestowed with Bharat Ratna posthumously under the Jan Morcha government. In the same year, Dr. Ambedkar life-size portrait was also unveiled in the Central Hall of Parliament. The period from 14 April 1990 to 14th April 1991 was observed as the year of social justice in the memory of Baba Saheb, champion of the poor and downtrodden. Dr. Ambedkar was very critically about the philosophy of Hinduism, Hindu social order, and riddles in Hinduism due to its inhuman caste practice. Dr. Ambedkar, the symbol of knowledge, in the Principle of Social and Political Theory, written by Professor Arnir Walker, he has dedicated his books to the preamble of Indian Constitution. The President of USA, Mr. Barack Obama, acknowledged Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as the father of Indian Constitution. Columbia University honored Dr. Ambedkar by D.Litt in 1954 for his great contribution in the writing Constitution. Dr. Ambedkar autobiography named Waiting for Vija, which he wrote during 1935 to 1936, is used as a textbook in the Columbia University. Columbia not only honored Baba Saheb but also set up a statue in Lehman Library, Columbia University, as a symbol of world knowledge. Then, a relevance of his idea. Dr. Ambedkar clearly proved that while women enjoyed the equal social status and economic independence in the pre-Manu age, their status declined in the post-Manu period due to the Manu Smriti. The treatise upheld the caste endogamy and it was responsible for the decline in the social status of women. Insuperability of the caste and gender inequality in Hindu social system, as enunciated by Ambedkar, is the key to understand the hurdles to empowerment of the woman and needs to be taken care of by Indian feminists. Dr. Ambedkar not only countered the orthodox Hindu views about the woman, but also worked at the grassroots level to organize and empower the women of the depressed classes so that they can battle for their rights, including the rights to drink water from the well, etc., and to enter the temples. Both rights were denied to them by the caste Hindu. Dr. Ambedkar encouraged a large number of the women to take streets to reclaim their social rights and self-respect. He spent his life for the betterment of the women, even those involved in professional like prostitutions. He impacted the lives of the life people. David was a pimp working of brothel at Kamantipura in Nagpur. Influenced by teaching of Ambedkar, he quit his profession. He even persuaded all the prostitutions to lead a life of honor. On the contrary, Manu only has contempt for women. He considered them slaves, devoid of intellectual. He denied them rights to acquire the knowledge and property, and forbids them from the performing sacrifice. As India's first law minister and chairman of drafting committee of the Constitution Assembly, Dr. Ambedkar thought its duty to free women from the slavery and reforming the Hindu social laws. He started Hindu Court Bill, the most formidable legislative measure of the modern India, sought among other reforms to put an end to a variety of marriage system prevailing in India and legalize only monogamous marriage. The code also showed to confirm on the woman rights of property and a doctrine which had been denied to them by the Manasuliti. Constitution of the provision, Article 14, equal rights and opportunity in political, economic and social phases. Article 15 forbids discrimination on this ground of the sex. Article 15 enable affirmative discrimination in the favor of a woman. Article 39 equal means of the livelihood and equal pay for equal work. Article 42 women condition of the work and maternity belief. Article 46 the state to promote with special care educational and interests of weaker of the people and protect them from the social justice all form of exploitation. Article 47 says the state to raise the level of the nutrition and standard of living of its people and improvement of the public health. Fundamental duties to renounce the practice derogatory to the denying of woman. Article 243 TD provides of all the allocation of the seats in Panchayati Raj. Let's conclude my paper. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was concerned with the status of women of all the sections of the society. He said that women must be treated equally with men. He tabled the Hindu Code Bill in Parliament and urged all the members to help pass the legislation. Eventually, he resigned for the same. The teaching and thoughts of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar are relevant not only for the women, but for all the Indians even today. His deep concern for the woman is evident from his every sentence and word. In the last speech in Indian Parliament, he quoted the famous words of very respected Nanan, "No man can be grateful at the cost of his honor, no woman can be grateful at the cost of her chastity, and no nation can be grateful at the cost of liberty." Dr. B.R. Ambedkar can be regarded as one of the greatest intellectual and social reformer of modern India, who struggled throughout his life for the liberation of the Indian women, particularly for the depressed classes, from the lifelong bondage and slavery imposed on them by the Hindu social institution. By conceptualizing the caste and gender inequality as the inseparable constitution of Hindu social order, Dr. Ambedkar laid down the foundation of India's march towards the gender justice. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay, thank you for that. And